There's a lot of never Trump Republican groups out there right now running ads, doing everything they can to make sure Donald Trump does not win re-election in November. Two of the big ones right now, obviously we have the Lincoln Project, which is being spearheaded by Kellyanne Conway's husband, George. And of course, now we have a new one, the 43 alumni for Biden, which is the former members of the George W. Bush administration who are working to get Joe Biden elected. So far, they haven't really done a whole heck of a lot, but the Lincoln Project has. They have released some really, really good ads targeting Donald Trump, making fun of Donald Trump, really getting under his skin in a way that has nothing to do with policy, but it's still good ads. And it's good that they're doing that, right? We don't want our candidate having to get down in the, you know, mud to do that kind of thing. Republicans fight very dirty. And so it's nice to have them on our side. But in all of this, let's not lose sight of one very important thing. These people are not our friends. These people might temporarily be our allies, but I think even calling them that is a bit of a stretch. These are Republicans who helped create the system that allowed Donald Trump to take over. These are Republicans who for years have been pushing the exact same policies that Donald Trump is pushing. They are no different than him. He is not unique among the Republican Party. He's just a little more outspoken, a little less polished than the rest of them. And that is what they have a problem with. And I have said this a million times, and I'll say it a million more if I have to. Republicans like Trump's policies. They just don't like him personally. That doesn't make them our friends. That doesn't make them our allies. It still means they are our enemies. And they would do the same thing he's doing if they were given a chance. They would just do it a little bit more politely or a little bit more covertly. That's what they want. They don't want the overt racism. They want the dog whistles. The dog whistles that are so high-pitched that most people don't even recognize them as dog whistles, except those that are being whistled to. They don't want him out there saying China's the enemy. They want somebody to say that a little more eloquently that makes you fully believe China's the enemy without them having to overtly tell you. You know, the subtlety of it, the nuance. That's what these Republicans want. They want the exact same policies, just delivered by somebody who's a little bit more palatable. Somebody who's not going to hurt down-ballot Republicans in November. That's what they're pissed about. They're going to lose the Senate, most likely. They're not going to retain the House, and they're likely going to lose the White House because of Donald Trump's personality. Once this election is over, those allies are going to go right back to obstructing every single progressive policy Democrats come up with. They are not our friends. But Lincoln Project is running some pretty hilarious ads that are getting under Trump's skin, so we allow it for now. But at the end of this, Democrats need to understand that we don't owe these Republicans anything, and it's time to fight back the second this election's over.